In the previous video, we had a look at how we could interact with these AI models, and we did that by instantiating a new instance of the chat OpenAI class, and we then called the invoke method, passing in our prompt. We can now take this one step further by assigning a prompt template to this model. Basically, prompt templates allow us to take control of the conversation, and we can use it to prime the model, and we can reformat the user's prompt in a very specific way. And we can also instruct the model to respond in a certain way. Let's have a look at this. First, let's activate our virtual environment in the terminal by running VENV scripts and activate. Let's create a new file called prompttemplates.py. Let's start by importing our environment variables, and let's also import chat OpenAI from the LangChain package. Let's create our LLM by calling the chat OpenAI class, and let's pass in a few parameters like a temperature of 0.7, and let's set our model to the newer GPT 3.5 Turbo 1106. Let's test our model by calling llm.invoke, and let's pass it this string. Tell me a joke about a chicken, and let's assign this to a variable called response. And then finally, let's print response. Let's test this in the terminal just to check if our model is working by running Python prompttemplates.py. And we get this message saying, why did the chicken join a band? Because it had the drumsticks. Awesome. Now let's have a look at what prompt templates can do for us. At the moment, the user is able to pass in pretty much any prompt into the model. So it can ask the model to tell a joke and pretty much anything else. But let's say we actually want to take control of this conversation and force this model to only tell jokes. So basically, we only want the user to pass in a subject, and our model will always generate the joke based on this word or subject. So let's have a look at how we can enforce that behavior. First, we need to import a prompt template from LangChain. So let's do that now. Let's type from LangChain core.prompts import the chat prompt template. Now let's create this template just below the LLM. I'll actually add a comment as well to say this is our prompt template. Let's also add a comment just above the LLM to say instantiate model. So let's create our prompt template by creating a variable called prompt, which is equal to chat prompt template. And this class provides a few methods for creating these prompts. But the first one we'll have a look at is the from template method. And this from templates method simply allows us to pass in a string. So let's actually copy the string from over here and add it to the prompt template. But now we can replace chicken with a variable by using curly braces. And let's give our variable a name like subject. Now we just need some way to combine our LLM with the prompt. And that leads us to the concept of chains in LangChain. Chains simply allow us to combine multiple objects together. So let's add a comment and let's say create LLM chain. Creating a chain is incredibly simple using the LangChain expression language. Let's first create a variable and let's just call it chain. And now to chain the LLM and the prompt together, we can simply enter the first object in the chain, which will be our prompt, and we can then add the LLM to this chain by using a pipe and then providing the LLM. This might seem a bit confusing, but it's actually quite simple. How these chains work is the output from this object will be passed in as input into this object, which makes sense in this case, right? We will first call the prompt template to get this formatted string, and it is this string or prompt that will be passed into the LLM as input. And then whatever output is produced by the LLM will be passed in as input in the next object in the chain. I hope that makes sense. Now, instead of invoking the LLM directly, we can simply invoke chain. We can also remove this prompt because instead of passing the entire prompt, we will now pass in the value for this variable, which we called subject. We can do that by passing in a dictionary, and here we can specify the name of the variable, which was subject, with a value of, let's say, dog. Let's test this out in the console by running our script. And as you can see, we did get our jug back. And by using this prompt template, we are now enforcing very specific behavior in our model. Let's have a look at another type of method for creating these prompt templates. And this is without a doubt my preferred way of creating these templates. On this class, let's call a method called fromMessages. This method takes in a list of values, basically a list of messages. And the first message in this list could be the system message. And a system message is a very special type of message which can be used to prime the model. So we can tell the model what its role is, what type of responses we want, etc. So let's pass it something like, you are an AI chef. Create a unique recipe based on the following main ingredient. Then let's pass another message, and this message will represent the input from ourselves. This is called the human input. And for its value, we can simply create a variable and let's call it input. If we wanted to, we could add additional messages to this list. And one use case for that is to provide examples of human input and AI responses to the model. I'll just leave it like this. So let's change this invoke value as well. Let's change it from subject to ingredient, and let's change it from dog, which I think would be a terrible ingredient, to tomatoes. Let's go ahead and run this in the terminal. And apologies, it's not ingredient. This should be called input, because in the prompt, that is what we called this variable. So in the terminal, let's run this again. And as expected, we do get our recipe back. We can also use prompt templates to tell the model to respond in a very specific format. Let's change the system message to something like, generate a list of 10 synonyms for the following word. Let's also say, return the results as a comma-separated list. Let's change this input from tomatoes to happy, and let's run this in the terminal. And now in the content field, we can see that we do indeed get these values back as a comma-separated list. But do take note that this is not a Python list, and this is still a string, so we will not be able to iterate over this. But thankfully, LangChain provides a super simple solution for taking this input and then converting it into any format that we want. And we'll have a look at these output parsers in the next video.